Fractions. Fraction as part of a whole. Srishti has a donut. She decided to share it equally with her friend Pinky. She cut the donut into two parts to form two equal halves. When a whole object is divided into an equal number of parts, each part is called a fraction. Thus, a fraction is the part of a whole object. Thus, Srishti eats one part and gives the other part to her friend Pinky. When Srishti divides the donut into two equal parts, each part is called one half. It is written as 1 upon 2 and read as 1 by 2. Look at the given figure. There are two equal parts of this shape. Each part is one half. One half of this shape is shaded blue. Thus, a fraction equals the number of parts shaded upon the total number of parts. Look at the given figure. When a whole object is divided into three equal parts, each part of an object is called one-third of the whole object. There are three equal parts. Each part is called one-third. If we shade one of the parts, then we say that one-third of this shape is shaded. The fraction one-third is written like this. And it read as 1 by 3. Now look at the given figure. The shape is divided into four equal parts. Each part is called a quarter or one-fourth. The one-fourth part is shaded blue. The fraction is written like this and is read as 1 by 4. Some more fractions. Shalini draws a circle with four equal parts and shades three parts. The fraction is written like this and read as 3/4. The remaining part of that circle is 1/4 of the whole circle. Let us look at some more parts of the shape and their shaded portions. Here, the circle is divided in eight equal parts, out of which three parts are shaded. So, the fraction of the circle that is shaded is 3 by 8. We write this fraction like this and read it as 3/8. Look at this shape. The square shape is divided into 8 equal parts. 1 out of 8 parts is colored, so the fraction is written like this and is read as 1/8. Numerator and denominator. A fraction comprised of two numbers separated by a horizontal line. The number above the horizontal line is known as the numerator, and the number below the horizontal line is known as the denominator. In this fraction, 1 is the numerator and 3 is the denominator. Fraction as a part of the group. Tina has 4 candies. 1 yellow candy and 3 red candies. There are 4 candies in all. 1/4 of the candies are yellow. And 3/4 of the candies are red. Look at the group of these 6 balls. Find 1/3 of 6. Since in the denominator, we have 3, divide the group of balls into 3 equal parts. How many balls are in each part? We have 2 balls in each part. Another way to find 1/3 of 6 is to divide 6 by 3, which is equal to 2. Let us find 2/3 of 6. To solve this problem, we take 6 balls. Divide the group of balls into 3 equal parts. How many balls are in 2 parts? So, 2/3 of 6 is 4. Fractions in real life. Himanj had 5 bananas. He ate 2 bananas. What fraction of bananas did he eat? Also tell what fraction of bananas are left. Fraction of bananas Himanj ate is 2/5. If Himanj eats 2 bananas, he is now left with 5 minus 2 is equal to 3 bananas. Fraction of bananas left is equal to 3 by 5.